All right, ladies and gentlemen, due to technical difficulties, I don't know what y'all missed. I don't know how much y'all missed. But we'll start here and hope for the best.
That is totally okay, Schaffner. Everybody makes mistakes, and I can, for one, tell you it's totally understandable. I've had so many problems with Bandicamp, it's ridiculous. Anyway, guys, especially you, Pop Town, because I know you're freaking watching, and we love you. Thanks to Princess and the mighty power of Google, I more or less have a basic explanation of what you've missed, because there are some important things you need to know. That if you don't mind looking at the still frame for just a few moments, I will take the time to explain to you right now. Let's see here. Okay, what we missed is that Ryder met with those who were in charge of the Nexus and colonization operations in Andromeda. But these guys weren't supposed to be in charge. The original leaders died before they got there, before they even woke up. So these new leaders are more or less ill-prepared to take over and handle everything that's going on. Not to mention that the other arcs are missing. There's this creepy dark matter we saw in the beginning of the game. They called it the Scourge. There's that going on. And so they are not getting along whatsoever. They don't like each other. They don't like each other at all. The original leaders actually crashed into the Scourge. And more or less, what's happening now is that Ryder is having to help everyone make nice. He's got to go find the other arcs, and he's really, just like any other Mass Effect game, is trying to make the best of a very bad situation. That's really all you missed. We're picking up immediately after he handled that, and I think that was it. Other than that, there was just some basic, you know, this is how you do this, this is how you do that, and yeah. Enjoy the rest of the episode.
Important head honcho person involved with the local militia, strike team stuff.
Real-time missions.
Real-time missions. We still got an hour and a quarter. Let's see here. Apex status. Lieutenant, based on status report 16C, it seems we are no closer to gaining a foothold in any sector. Without decent recon and greater intel on this enemy, I'm starting to think our efforts are futile. The risks involved in continued loss of resources and lives make it hard to justify. With morale this low, we need to scale down expectations again. Kandros. Alright.
As far as the havoc of the Nexus, there are apparently four groups that don't work together at all. They just talk at each other. And then there's a Krogan clan that they decide to screw.
I'll find her.
No time for our beer yet. This place is a mess. Security is it. Let's call it strained.
I can believe it. The Nexus is running on empty.
Not just that. A lot of the exiles were security. Everyone was trained and armed for Frontier. We know Ket are dangerous, and now we have to worry about our people too. No idea where they went, but they left mad.
They were frustrated. If they just wanted to kill, they could have fought to the last here.
Apparently, we're the big hope for everyone. Not the Hyperion showing. Just us. I'm with you. It's just a lot.
As long as the Nexus is here, as long as we're here, we have a job to do.
Yeah.
Double down crisis mode. I can do that. We can do that. Ready and willing, Pathfinder.
Let's see here.
Toxic. What if they store oxygen in porous tissue, like Quiro's rockfish?
I still reckon they had breather gear stowed in that armor.
Perhaps both. Life is infinitely adaptable, as our expedition proves.
Can I talk to you? Thank you.
You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Herrick. My colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
Yeah.
You okay, man? He's not moving. Mr. Tyrion there's not moving.
He's analyzing you.
Uh-huh.
What fields do you study?
Herrick's into life sciences. I do planetary geology, oceanography, rocks and runoff. Aradana's the space and math whiz.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Hi, Pathfinder. Want to hit some rocks for science?
Try and stop me.
Absolutely. What do you need?
Sam and I used your scans and made a VI for geophysics surveys. Beta build's on the console there. Test it out in the field, and I'll wrangle you a consultant's bonus from Director Addison. How's that sound?
His head moves, but his body just does not.
Pathfinder, we've had some trouble.
Anything I can help with?
Perhaps. I discharged an away team to get readings from a section of the Scourge that was behaving anomalously. They haven't reported in for some time, and sensors can't locate their shuttle. I sent them out there. Good, dedicated people. I fear what might have happened to them.
Your work is important. Don't lose sight of that. When I'm out there, I'll see if I can find them.
Their friends and family will want to know what's happened, and I need to know.
Why do I have issues talking to you?
Pathfinder, those bioscans are superb. Could you gather more for our comparative conservation effort?
Don't walk away from me.
What conservation
He's
effort?
He's busy!
Ah, my thesis is on the console there. Broad strokes, we're comparing and preserving organisms from both galaxies. If you donate more bioscans and samples to the catalog, I can get you a finder's fee. Tempted?
Console
is having issues.
Console is awfully shooty, spark.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Alright.
Damn. This is a lot to read.
This is a lot to read.
Just give it about 10 seconds and then let everybody read it so that they can pause it. Yeah, just pause it when we change people. This is a lot to process and read out loud.
I said it. All right. Hyperion docking procedures
are now complete. Oh, I can't wait to play this game on my own. Hurry up, beat it.
I'm working on it. I apparently have not been in that room before. Because I'm playing this on my own to see what is reasonably relevant.
Weapons and stuff. I got you covered. Use the console to take a look through what I got. It'd be a lot easier if I weren't missing half my stock.
You got it. Shop till you drop. Here I come.
That's fine. Hey, wait. Please don't drop anything you bought from me, okay? Tam would have my head if anything happened to you on my account.
Let's
guns!
See. Sell all my crap.
Guns! Glorious guns!
Want you tempted?
Oh, there's your credits.
Yeah. I want you. Confirm trade. All right.
You bought a toy.
I bought a new toy. All right.
This is Super Salty Gamers. HR reporting. Weapons are not toys. Do not use them as such. Blah, 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 blah.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we've found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
Good. I was starting to wonder who was in charge around here.
Director Addison is entitled to her opinion. And mine overrules ours.
Does she know that?
Wow.
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself.
All right,
to that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the Golden Worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable. So, how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Just point me to my ship and I'll be out of here.
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. No. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that.
Something wrong?
Ryder, KC, me and Sam node on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No, I'm fine.
Right.
Ryder. You have my condolences for your father.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
They're as much a part of the initiative as the human arc. We'll find them.
We have to. Tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
Any more information you can give me on the missing arcs?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian arcs are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other arcs, the promise of the initiative can never be fulfilled.
Are there any other arcs we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave. But before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any hostile threats. Whether that's the Ket or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on site can be discouraging. Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any Pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
I'm still expecting Thresher Maw.
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
You know, I like this guy. He seems like a very likable person.
But his agenda is worrisome.
But his leadership capabilities are not to standard.
His leadership abilities are ridiculous, and his agenda worries me as well.
Well, really, what the Krogan lady said is accurate. He's a little bit of a bigot towards Krogan, but he wants things to succeed. But that's about it.
And he's a douche.
He is a bit of a prick, but I kind of like him. I don't even know exactly why.
It sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly? I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you... It's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds, many of them our senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, is dead.
How did Gian Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Gian Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
Kendris mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we call them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them. Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen? Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
There don't seem to be many Krogan around.
Good riddance. The Krogan demanded a greater say in political matters. The last place you want them involved. Their muscle, nothing more. Good for fighting and lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts. What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
What more can you tell me about the initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. Uh-huh. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
What do you know about the early days of the initiative?
As most everyone knows, Gian Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands of reasons. One for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them. The thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arcs. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix. As a Solarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
As director of the initiative, are you in charge around here or what?
If the others would allow me, they don't see me as the rightful successor.
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles, some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
God.
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the initiative, and saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry. That's all. Thanks for your time.
I'm happy to help. You will find our futures depend on each other's success. Good luck.
So yeah, that's why.
I can't remember all these people's names.
Oh yeah, no, I'm not even gonna try.
I mean, eventually you will, but God.
Oh, right. I suppose. It's not that important.
Be aware of any suspicious activity. Security is on heightened alert.
When I said I was going to take a look inside the panel.
Oh. Woman. Woman.
Hey there.
You okay? Those guys really grilled you. And Addison. First Pathfinder they've seen in over a year. All she can do is question your competence?
Huh.
I expected something like that. I can handle the pressure.
Good to hear. I worked out logistics with Director Tan. They're giving us a ship and crew. He said their best is taking care of it.
I still need to head back to the Ark and check in with Sam.
Sounds good. While you're there, maybe see how your sister's doing.
What's really pitying is that you probably won't even see the completion of any of this. You'll have to wait till number two.
Yep. Oh, why am I going back here? All these places look the same. I mean, look at
Welcome
this.
Welcome to the Nexus, i.e.
No, this is the Ark.
Oh, this is the Ark?
Yeah, the Hyperion.
Oh, it is the Hyperion. Well, welcome to... Well, it's part of the Nexus now, so it's the Nexus. It's not like they're going to take it out. Where is she?
Well, she's... Doc, you, Doc.
Ryder,
doctor, give
you.
Me the news.
Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
I haven't heard how he died.
Like a hero. That's how. That's the only part that matters.
Suffocating.
I've met one Pathfinder. Well, two with you. But I figure that's the way to go. Taking your last breath on an uncharted world.
Yeah. Sounds about right.
Now I just need to make sure your sister here pulls through.
How's Sarah doing?
Her condition's stable. I see signs of REM activity in the brain, so she's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
How'd this happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the scourge at the worst possible moment, just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another Ryder.
Are you staying here on the Hyperion?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by.
We'll miss you, Harry.
Just make sure to raise some hell once in a while, will you? I'm living vicariously through you.
Deal. How did you end up with the initiative?
Well, you reach a point in life where you wonder, is that all there is? I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. A chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of arthritis.
Fair enough.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
I can respect that.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Sarah, I'll let you know.
All right. Well, that was slightly anticlimactic.
boop.
Did you just boop me?
No.
Are you lying to me?
No.
I saw you pick up that stick. No. No, I didn't boop you.
Lies.
Don't make me take that away from you.
I'll
take that away from you.
How do you know?
Because I know things.
You shouldn't know that much.
I know plenty, though.
That much knowledge kills. Me.
Enough. Enough knowledge will kill you.
I win!
Hello, Ryder. Welcome back to Samnode. I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential.
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best we speak alone.
I don't understand the need for secrecy.
Your father felt it was for the best.
What was he trying to hide?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's me now.
And only you. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required.
Whoa.
Alec called them profiles. They provide unique tactical augmentation during combat. Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
I can understand. People might get the wrong idea.
You're an AI. You're a monster.
A computer having control over a human.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient. Far beyond what even the initiative understands.
I don't follow.
Of course it does.
You're an AI. So what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
All personnel should check with their supervisor before taking leave.
That's pretty amazing.
But beyond what many people will accept, your father knew some would fear it.
Yeah, he's got a point. So what does this mean for the two of us?
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a Pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed. Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters. In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Thanks.
Ooh.
Yeah, all this is basically saying it's increases tech stuff or biotic stuff, or a combination thereof.
So you can switch?
I think so. I mean, this one's the jack of all trades. If you, cause the, because the way you level up in this game is you have access to everything.
Oh boy.
But it's not going to be wise to put points into everything.
Nope.
Unless you know exactly what you're doing, which
now
I
must focus.
Do not. I definitely need to focus.
On combat.
On combat.
Mass naughtiness.
Oh,
the points multiply, I see.
Yep.
Again.
X. Yes. Ah, damn freaking.
I love how you said yes and then you I see. This is neat.
Right? It's not a bad system, and they simplify your people.
Oh yeah. Your people are,
they don't have all the options like you do.
Sorry background, huh?
Right. It's pretty neat.
No, oh, Nova. Nova is violent.
Yes. Nova is going to save my ass.
Yeah, I remember Nova. That one was violent. Is another biotic?
Pretty much, yeah.
Hmm.
Ah, no, cancel. There we go. Yes. There we go.
Everybody's ready.
Everybody's basically ready.
Printed books.
Reproductions of Lewis and Clark's journals, detailing their expedition in the 19th century.
Explains Dad's interest. They were pathfinders too.
You can actually follow
that trail.
Your father's
first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Alec's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Crazy times.
You can actually follow the Lewis and Clark trail because they both had, one of them at least had syphilis, or somebody in the group had syphilis. And the cure back then for syphilis was mercury. So you can literally follow their trail by looking for mercury deposits in the road that they took.
So this tells me this took place after Mass Effect, the first Mass Effect, because Normandy SR2. Because I was under the assumption this took place before Mass Effect.
Apparently not. I didn't pay attention to the years very much.
I didn't either. So, there's that. Coffee!
The coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you. Needed the caffeine.
I did not realize I owed my existence to a bean.
And now you know what humility feels like. Sam, what was that?
An eidetic trigger related to your father and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Alec tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Samnode on the Hyperion to investigate further. Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories which Alec wanted you to see.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Okay, something new every day. Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive. But an AI can.
How?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both. There's no creator to revolt against.
I'm sorry, Alec. We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied.
Alec? Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
Not on my watch.
Oh, boy.
Wow. Hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Alec was a stubborn man.
It's how Dad was wired. He didn't like to lose, in any situation.
It would seem that included me.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it. That's all for now.
Of course.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you. It is our time up, and it's a blast. We'll see you again. Stay salty.